गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. लास्ट क्लास वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट प्रिपरेशन ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एंड फिजिकल केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. सो ओवरऑल ऑक्सीजन इज मेनली डाई ऑक्सीजन एंड ट्राई ऑक्सीजन, दैट इज ओजोन. सो ऑलरेडी वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट प्रिपरेशन ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एंड ओजोन एंड केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एंड ओजोन. नेक्स्ट फर्दर वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट सल्फर. सो ओवरऑल सल्फर इज मेनली अवेलेबल इन टू टाइप्स. ओके, सो टू टाइप्स ऑफ एलोट्रोफिक प्रॉपर्टी. So that is number one, rhombic sulfur, and next second one, monoclinic sulfur. Rhombic sulfur and monoclinic sulfur. So this rhombic sulfur is also called alpha sulfur. Monoclinic sulfur is also called beta sulfur. Okay, so sulfur is mainly available from two types of allotropy. So that is rhombic sulfur. It is also called alpha sulfur. Second one, monoclinic sulfur. It is also called beta sulfur. So when heated up this rhombic sulfur at a 369 Kelvin temperature, so it is converted to monoclinic sulfur. Okay, when heated up rhombic sulfur at a 369 Kelvin temperature to form monoclinic sulfur or beta sulfur. So overall rhombic sulfur and monoclinic sulfur. So alpha sulfur, that is already know that rhombic sulfur, so it's contained yellow color. Alpha sulfur or rhombic sulfur contain yellow color. So commonly this solid compound and so when so overall melting point of alpha sulfur is 385.8 Kelvin temperature, so it is dissolved in CS2. Okay, at the same time just like it is dissolved in benzene or alcohol, means like a different types of alcohols are there, methyl alcohol or ethyl alcohol. Okay, next it is also soluble in the ethers, so like a dimethyl ether or a diethyl ether. Okay, so overall it is does not soluble in water. Okay, so alpha sulfur or rhombic sulfur, solid yellow compound. So overall it has a 385.8 Kelvin melting point. It is soluble in CS2, means carbon disulfide, and like a benzene. Next ethers, alcohol. It is does not soluble in water molecules. Okay, next further is like alpha sulfur. Next further beta sulfur. So beta sulfur is monoclinic sulfur, so it is a solid compound. So overall it has a 392 Kelvin melting point. So it is also soluble in CS2, carbon disulfide. Okay, so beta sulfur. It is a mainly solid compound. Next, it has contain 392 Kelvin melting point, and it has dissolved in CH2, carbon disulfide. Okay, so overall sulfur is mainly its contain is 8. So 8 atoms. Okay, is 8 form. So overall it has structure just like a so it is structure of sulfur. So each corner one sulfur, so total 8 sulfur atoms. So between sulfur and sulfur is contained, so bond length 204 picometers, like it is like a 204 between sulfur and sulfur. The bond angle between sulfur, sulfur, sulfur is a 107 degree. Okay, so S8, sulfur is always contain 8 atoms, so S8 form. So overall in these structures between sulfur to sulfur, bond length or bond distance, that is 204 picometers, and a bond angle 107 degree. Okay, so it is a structure of S8. So overall, next further, sulfur very important compound, sulfur dioxide. So what is preparation of sulfur dioxide and chemical properties? Now first, preparation of sulfur dioxide. So overall, when heated of sulfur in the presence of oxygen, to form sulfur dioxide. Okay, when heated of sulfur in the presence of oxygen to form sulfur dioxide. Next further, when heated of metal sulfides in the presence of oxygen to form sulfur dioxide. Suppose for example, when we have taken ZnS, so zinc sulfide or zinc blend, when heated of the zinc blend, so in the presence of oxygen to form in this reaction, so ZnO means zinc oxide. Okay, next to further, sulfur dioxide SO2. Okay, sulfur dioxide SO2. When heated of zinc sulfide in the presence of oxygen to form zinc oxide and sulfur dioxide. Okay, next another preparation. Suppose we have taken FeS2. So iron sulfide or ferrous sulfide, when this ferrous sulfide is reaction with oxygen to form the reaction Fe2O3. So iron trioxide, just like rusting, iron trioxide. And next further, to form SO2, sulfur dioxide. Okay, so when we have taken FeS2, iron sulfide or ferrous sulfide, when heated up this iron sulfide in the presence of oxygen to form in this reaction Fe2O3, iron trioxide and sulfur dioxide. So it is preparation of sulfur dioxide. So next further, what is the physical properties of sulfur dioxide? So overall, sulfur dioxide is a gaseous compound. So it is colorless and has fungi smell, and it is soluble in water molecules. When sulfur dioxide is soluble in water molecules to form H2SO3. H2SO3 means sulfurous acid. Okay, so overall sulfur dioxide is a gas. It is colorless and fungi smell. So it is soluble in water molecules to form H2SO3, sulfurous acid. Okay, next, what is the chemical properties? So overall, sulfur dioxide is reacts with a number of different types of compounds. Suppose, for example, so it is reacts with sodium hydroxide. When sodium hydroxide is reacts with sulfur dioxide, to form in this reaction Na2SO3. So Na2SO3 means sodium sulfite. Okay, Na2SO3 means sodium sulfite. And next further, water molecules. Next further, this Na2SO3 sodium sulfite. This sodium sulfite is reaction with the sulfur dioxide and water molecules to form the reaction NaHSO3. So NaHSO3 means sodium hydrogen sulfite or sodium bisulfite. Okay, so sodium sulfite is reacts with the sulfur dioxide and water molecules to form in this reaction. So NaHSO3, sodium hydrogen sulfite or sodium bisulfite. Okay, next further, so it is reaction with the chlorine. So chlorine reaction with the SO2 sulfur dioxide to form SO2Cl2. So means sulfuryl chloride. Sulfuryl chloride. So chlorine is mainly used for bleaching purpose in a textile industries. So bleaching means color compounds is converted to colorless compounds. When we have used that chlorine, so that chlorine is occupied on the surface of cloths. So that is that time we have removed the chlorine on the surface of cloth, we have used a sulfur dioxide. So that's why sulfur dioxide is just like we have used antichlore. Antichlore means remove of chlorine. Okay, when we have used sulfur dioxide. Okay, remove of chlorine, we have used sulfur dioxide. Okay, overall sulfur dioxide is reacts with chlorine to form sulfuryl chloride. Next further, it is reacts with the